हेलो सर,
मैम गुड आफ्टरनून
नमस्ते
मैम।
सर। गुड
नमस्ते
आफ्टरनून
मैम।
सर।
हाँ मैम ऑडिबल मैम।
हाँ यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल सर।
ओके मैम। Yes,
Sir,
ma'am.
you have been made a co-host, sir. Once you can share your screen and check, sir. Otherwise, we will share.
I think it is sharing, no problem.
What, sir? You will share, sir.
Yeah, now it is.
Okay, sir.
Now
Yes,
it is
sir,
the
it is visible.
visible
It's
ma'am.
visible. Huh, yes, sir.
Okay ma'am.
Okay,
Shall I
sir.
keep this one or shall I remove this one?
They will change, sir. You need not worry, sir.
Okay.
Shall I start, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Om Shri Dhanvantaraya Namaha. Om Shri Guru Basabalingaya Namaha. A very good afternoon to one and all. And myself, Dr. Mukta Arale, reader, Department of Dravyaguna, Sri Vijay Mahantesh Ayurved Medical College, Ilkal, welcomes you all to the Dravya Sampada 2020, a national webinar series on Dravyaguna. So today we have another eminent speaker, Dr. Om Prakash Rao, sir, with us. Now let me take the privilege of introducing today's speaker. Dr. Om Prakash Rao completed his BAMS from Sri Narsingarh Ayurvedic College and Research Institute, Narsinghnath, Orissa, and a postgraduate diploma in preventive and promotive healthcare from Apollo Hospital, Hospitals Educational and Research Foundation, Hyderabad, and sir did his MD and MD from in Dravyaguna from KLE Sri BM Kankanavade Ayurvedic Mahavidyalaya, Belgaum, and PhD from Utkal University, Bhuvaneshwar. And sir worked as a research associate in the sponsored project development of standard operating procedures of manufacturing process of compound Ayurvedic Unani Siddha formulations and their pharmacopeial standards by Department of Ayush and Bioremedies Cell Department of Regional Research Lab, CSIR, Bhubaneswar. Sir also worked as a lecturer in Rajiv Lochan Ayurved Medical College and Hospital, Durg, Chhattisgarh, and presently working as a reader, Department of Dravyaguna, Government Ayurvedic Medical College, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Sir guided 10 postgraduate research scholars and 4 are ongoing. And sir presented 14 monographs published in the Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia of India, Part 2, Volume 3. Sir co-authored 1 book, Practical Dravyaguna Vijnana, which is published from Chaukamba Krishnadas Academy, Varanasi. And sir presented 5 research articles published 5 research articles in peer-reviewed national and international journals and presented 15 research papers at different international and national seminars. And sir is also working as an administrative in Dravyaguna expert committee member for licensing and approval of Ayurveda, Siddha and Unani drugs, Government of Chhattisgarh, Health and Family Welfare Department, Raipur. And sir is also a member of Board of Studies, Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay Memorial Health Sciences and Ayush University, Chhattisgarh. Sir is also a member of Institutional Research Development Committee, Government of Ayurveda College, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Thank you, sir. We are pleased to have you with us today, sir. Welcome, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
And just before we begin, there are a few instructions to the participants. Please display your full name. Try to maintain timings. Turn off your audio and video while joining the session. All queries can be posted in the chat box and we shall go through them once the session is over. In case of any disruption, kindly check your network connection and wait patiently for the session to resume. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Shall I share, ma'am?
Yes, sir, you can share.
Okay, it is visible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. It gives me great pleasure in presenting before you and sharing with this webinar series my views on the basic concept of Dravyaguna. Let me thank the organizer of this webinar series for inviting me to present my topic. So my topic is the basic concept of Dravyaguna, but in the sense it is a big point, but I am sharing some little point, not the, I can say the big point, the little points. So why I'm choosing this topic? It is not, I'm facing problem, ma'am. That is the, it is not the shifted.
Okay, sir, we will share, sir.
Okay, we just share, ma'am.
Okay, sir.
Okay. The topic I am presenting here, that main point is the basic concept of Dravyagun. So in the whole presentation, I divided into the 6 points. In 6 points, I am first starting the Dravyagun in the question mark. Next, it is the classical Ayurvedic books now converted into short notes. After that, it is going to the mobile PDF file. So in this case, are you missing some basic concept in the original textbooks? That we will discuss later. Next point, the basic principle of Dravyagun Vigyan. What are the principles we are getting knowledge in the Dravyagun Vigyan? You should be know. Next, applied aspects of Dravyagun. Next, interpretation of the research in the Madhav Nidan. It is the clinical interest topic point. And last point, that is the interpretation of the drug, that is the Guruchi. So here I present the point, how you read the Madhav, that is the Bhav plus Nighantu Shlokas. Next. In my first point, I highlighted the point Dravyagun with the question mark. We are thinking the Dravyagun, just previous one. We are thinking that Dravyagun, it is the clinical subject or non-clinical subject. If it is clinical, somebody say that it is okay, we will go for Dravyagun. Or somebody say it is a non-clinical subject, so it is a question mark, whether this is the good for me or not. After that, we go for the carrier cases. If I go for Dravyagun, what is my carrier? So always it is the question mark. So people are thinking about this. If they are not getting any non-clinical subject, then they opted for the Dravyagun as a non-clinical subject. Next. Now, in Dravyagun, where you will get the syllabus point or any topics, it is in the undergraduate syllabus, it is in the postgraduate syllabus. There is other three courses are there, that is the postgraduate diploma in Ayurvedic pharmacognosy and standardization, that is Dravyagun Vigyan, and it is the PhD in the Dravyagun, and M Pharma Ayurved Dravyagun. Next. See, if you were BMS graduates and you have the proper knowledge in the subjects, you have the commanding subjects, then you go for the settle in the peripheral areas of cities or rural belt, you go for any good clinical practice. If you, the true fact is there, the best practitioners, simply they are the BMS, not MD. If you search any data you have, the simple BMS graduates are the good clinical practitioners. So after BMS graduate, you can go for the clinical practice. Then another option there, you can have the Ayurvedic clinical practice, that is what is another ACP, go to hospital, nursing home, you can go. Next, there is the Ayurvedic Drug Manufacturing Unit, that is the ABM. Another sense, you can have own personal Ayurvedic pharmacy for your clinical practice. It is a good career for a BMS graduates. Next. Next, ma'am. Next, previous one. MD Dravyagun, this one. This is the, you have degree in the MD, then what are the opportunities are there? In the, as per the rules, in the Pharmacopeial Commissions of the Indian Medicine, Ghaziabad, there is required the MD Dravyagun. In the central cases and in state cases, there is required the degree for the drug inspectors and drug controllers. And in the Ayurvedic Siddha Yunani Drugs Technical Advisory Board, there is required of the one teacher in the Dravyagun. Next, in the Ayurvedic Manufacturing Pharmacy, there should be technical person who have the degree that the MD Dravyagun. Next, in the teaching faculty, he or she must have the MD degree in the Dravyagun. Next. See, in the Dravyagun, there is the good opportunity in the regulatory affairs. because in regulatory affairs, it is a critical role to play so as to meet the international standards. For this, it is required a proper knowledge of Dravigun for understanding the content of the API, that is the Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia of India, and API, that is the Ayurvedic Formulary of India. And lastly, the main point is the essential drug list of Ayurveda. And it is the exposure area of the Dravigun people, that is the pharmacognosy, pharmacy, pharmaceutics, pharmacology, phytochemistry, and ethnopharmacology. Next. See, there is some pictures are there. In one picture, the books are there. One library is there, which is totally empty. And second, it is the books, only single books, and there is mobile is there. So the point is that our books are, the main books are the classical Ayurvedic books, not the reference books. What happened nowadays, we are purchasing reference book, not purchasing any original classical books. From reference book, we are making short notes. From short notes, we again transport into the mobile PDF file. So what happened is, the main textbooks we are missing. We are not utilizing our library properly because we have mobiles, Android phone, then all the things are in the scanning mode and stored in our mobile. So what happened? It is the classical Ayurvedic books converted subsequently the present mode of study, reference books, in reference book from the short notes, from short note into the mobile PDF file. Next. See, in the second VMS, Dravigun, there are the four subjects are there, Dravigun Vigyan, Rog Nidan, Ras Shastra Vaishya Kalpana, and Charak Sainta. What happened? When we are studying these four subjects, we are not correlating to with each other. Dravigun means it is the basic chapter point, paper one and paper two, detail, non-detail drugs. That's all. But there is the some correlation between these four subjects. If you go Dravyagun Vigyan, that is the Rasa, Guna, Virya, Vipaka, Prabhava. In Karma, that is the main point is the Dosha Karma, Dhatu Karma, Mala Karma. When it is Rasa Shastra, it is the Sangraha, Sanskarana, Shodhana, Mana, Anakabiddha Kalpana, Savirya Avadi, and Vitarana. In Rog Nidan, it is the Nidan Panchaka and Samprati. And Charasenta, it is the basic point of the and the view of the medicines. Next. See, this is the pictures. There is Charak Sainta, Srishti Sainta, Ashtang Hrudaya, Bhav Prakash. I am not going in the Bhav Prakash Nigan too. I am simply present the book cover, that is the Bhav Prakash, Madhav Nidan and Sangda Sainta. So I think and the verbally or literally, you know this, all the six books. But next. Next, man. See, before one, this one, this previous one. There is a six rasas are there. Madhura, Amla, Labana, Katu, Tikta, Kasaya. In the six lines, total chapter of the rasa completed. In serial number, rasa, guna, karma, dosa, prabhava, atishavana, janya, vikara. That's all. These type of notebooks are short notes, a PDF file, it will be available in the mobile and your bags. So if this thing will happen, whether it is fulfilled for our treatment line. So that's why in previous slide, I am giving them some point that how the original textbooks are the reference book, then it is the short notes, then it is the PDF file. Next. See, in one line, the drug concept complete. This is also available in the mobile PDF file. in one simple, that is the, what is the botanical Sanskrit name, what is the family, what is the Latin name, what is the habit, habitat, what is the rasaguna, viribhipaka, prayoga, where it is available, and what are the formulas are there. Okay, this much data of a drug, can it fulfill our clinical data, a clinical treatment? It should be observed, or it should be justified that whether this data is sufficient for us. Next. See, the basic principle of Dravyaguna Vigyan, it is not a small point, it is a big point. Because Dravyaguna Vigyan, there are two divisions, one is the Padartha Vigyan and Dravya Vigyan. Again, in Dravya Vigyan, it is a Namrupa Vigyan, Yoga Vigyan, Sanyoga Vigyan. In Yoga Vigyan, it is again two, that is the Gunakarma Vigyan and Prayoga Vigyan. So, individual chapters have its own importance. We cannot say that this much I know and it will go for the better in my future. No, you should be correlated, it should be thorough study, and it should be with the original classical textbooks. Next. See, the principles are there. What is that? All are in the Dravyaguna Vigyan book, that is the Dravya Ashrita Rasadi Gunanam, Sarva Dravyam Pancha Bhautikam, that is Osadhatam, that is the Dravya Vagyakarana, Dravyanam Namakarana, Pariyayanama, Chatushpada, Sangraha Vidhi, Oshada Yoga, Bhesaja Kala, Bhesaja Prayoga, Oshada Matra, Anupana, Oshada Vyavastha Patra. So all the basic points are in our Dravyaguna paper one in the second BMS syllabus. So it have own importance in the every chapters. Next. See, I think my shloka is not supporting here. This is from the Raj Nigantu. That is the three pictures are there, Nigantu, grammar, and arrow, bow and arrow. So at that, state that if a physician does not know about the Nigantu, here is the first line, it's mentioned that Nigantu is most important point in the Dravyaguna. A scholar without the knowledge of rules of grammar, and a person trying to use bow and arrow without the proper practice, all are the laughing stock. It should be remembered by the everybody that if Dravyaguna is there is Nigantu must. We cannot say that Nigantu not is required for this. In Dravyaguna, Nigantu is the basic fundamental point in the Dravyaguna cases. Next. See, in the two slides, I just try to set up how many Nigantus and Hyperbole books are there. In starting from the Vedic Nigantu, Srushrut Nigantu, Rasa Vaisheshika, Ashtanga Nigantu, Pariyaya Ratnamala, Siddhasara Nigantu, Haramakhala Nigantu, Chamatkar Nigantu, Madanadi Nigantu, Dravyaguna Kara, Dravyaguna Sangraha, Dhanantari Nigantu, Indu Nigantu, Nimi Nigantu, Arundhat Nigantu, Sabda Chandrika, Vaspachandra Nigantu. These are the Nigantus already in the our classical text. Next slide. See, it is total number, I think it is the total 61. Just I'm missing that, see, number 60 and 61. So these are things how in the 32 number, it is the Bhavprakash Nigantu. The Bhav means the 16th century AD, which is we are give the basic fundamental of the Dravya. Next. See. As per the data, one should be know Bhavprakash Nigantu, Raj Nigantu, Madanpal Nigantu, Kaidav Nigantu, and Dhanantar Nigantu. Minimum. This is five Nigantu. Minimum five Nigantu should know by the everybody. That what are the differences when they are describing of the drugs, because when they are in the Nigantus, the drugs, when in the slokas, you can get the 3 points. One is the synonyms, second is the Gunakarma, and third one is the Prayoga. So every Nigantu has own expertise area. They are giving some new names as a synonyms, new gunakarma adding with the others nighantus which is correlated with you. Next, again in the prayoga there is given some extra point you will be get on the analysis. Next, see the main most important points is the dravya guna, that is the applied aspects. In applied aspects there is the 31 points. In 31 points what are they? It is the prakriti, vaya, bala, sharira, sattva, agni, moola, anubandha, grahani, desha, kala, ushada kala, dosha, dosha sthana, vyadhi vishesha, vyadhi sthana, purusha vishesha, satmya, kriya, vikriya, vishesha, matra, abhijnana, anarogya, prayatva, arogya prayatva, vyapat, siddhi. Next, dravya, rasa, guna, virya, vipaka, karma. So before 28 number points, one should be know what are the 27 points. So on the basis, you can fulfill your treatment line after knowing the dravya guna. So prakriti, vaya, vala, sarira, sattva, agni, moola, anubandha, grahani, desha, kala, ushada kala, dosha. These are the fundamental points one should be know in the proper way. That's why after knowing all the 31 points, he or she can be go for the applied expert of the dravya guna. It is a big task, but if you go for the thoroughly study, then one can be successful. Next. See, in my motto, I'm just correlating with the Bhavprakash concept in the Madhav Nidhan. I am not taking here Bhavprakash Nighantu because one chapter is there in Bhavprakash Nighantu, that is the Mishra Varga. In Mishra Varga, basic fundamental point of dravya guna are mentioned, so that's why I am taking the Bhavprakash and it is the Madhav Nidhan. Next. See, I am not going in the detail elaborate point, just highlighting the main points. In the Samprati, that is the Chaya, Prakopa, Prasara, Sthana, Sansaya, and Vikta. In the sides, it is the Koshta, General Circulation, Particular, and Shrutas and Dushya. And here it is the Rasa, Vipaka, Guna, Vira, Prabhava. In the main point here, that if it is Koshta, there is Chaya and Prakopa. In Chaya cases, the Rasa is the drug potency acting on this side. If it is Prakopa, then it is the Vipaka. If it is the prasara stage, the guna will be active. Next, if the sthana sansaya, the virya is there. If it is the vyakta, that is the prabhava. That's why in the drug, we are in the point of the rasa panchaka. Everybody should know the rasa panchaka of a particular drug, because these 5 points are correlated with the chaya, prakopa, prasara, sthana sansaya, and vyakta. I'm giving two examples here. One is the Atisara, second one is the Rakta Stambana. In Atisara, that is the dosha, that is the Vata dosha. The main drug is the Sunthi. Sunthi will be act here in the dosha. If it is Dushya Purisha, then Bhanga. Then if the Shrotas, it is the Purisha or Shrotas, it is the Ahipaina. Because the main point is the different drugs may act on the different constitution of the Samprati. Because what happened in the main point Sunthi? Sunthi is the Kattukattu Ushna and it is the Madhura Vipaka. It is Kapha Vatagna. In main property is the Dipana Pachana. In the Bhanga, it is the Tiktakattu Ushna and Guna is the Laghu Tikshna. Because here it is the Dipan Pachana and Grahi. In Ahipana, it is the Tiktakasaya, Kattu Ushna and mainly it is the Grahi and Madakari. So what happened here there? If drug is Shunti, the best choice of the act in the dosha, that is the Vata dosha. If it is Bhanga here, it is act on the Purisha in the Dushya. And the hyphen is, it is a prescription, it should be on the basis of the Purisha or Shrota, that is the Shrotas. In Rastastambha Karma, it is the three drug places there. One the Nakyasara, second is the Mocharasa, third is the Lodhra. Nakyasara is well known for the Raktarsha, Mucharasa is only for the Rakta Pradara and Lodhra is only for the Rakta Tishara. In the three cases, dosa is the same, that is the Pitta dosha, and it is the Dushya, that is the Rakta. So in three cases, dosha and Dushya are same, but the main point is the involvement of the Shrotas. So under the Shrotas involvement, the drug of choice is the different. That's it, the Nakyasara is the Rakta, Raktarsha, Mucharasa is the Rakta Pradara, and Ludra is the Raktadishara. Next. See, this is the topic names of the Madhav Nidana. The first point is the Panchalakshan Nidana. Next is the starting from the Jwara, Atishara, Grahani, Arsha, Agnimanda, Ajinna, Visuchika, Alashaka, Vilambika, Krimi, Pandurvaga, Kamala, Kumbhakamala, Halimaka, Raktapita, Radayakshma, Kshetakshina, Kasanidana, Hikashasa, Swarabheda, Arachaka, Chardi, Krishna, Mursha, Brahma, Nidra, Tandra, Sanyas, Anatraya, Daha, Unmada, Apashmara, Vatavedi, Vatarakta, Urustamba, Amabata, Shula, Parinama Shula, Anadrava Shula, Udavarta, Anaha, Gulma, Hridra, Mutrakusha, Mutraghata, Ashmari, Prameha Pidika, Prameha and Prameha Pidika, Medoraga, Udaroga, Shotha, Vriddhi, Galaganda, Gandamala, Apachi, Granthi, Arbut, Slipat, Vidradhi, Branashotha, Saribrana, Sadhubrana. Next. Bhagna, Nadibrana, Bhagandara, Upadangsha, Sukadosha, Kushta, Sitta Pitta, Udarda Kota, Amlapitta, Visharpa, Pishpata, Mashudika, Chidradoga, Mukhoroga, Kannaroga, Nasa, Netra, Siraroga, Asrugada, Yoni Vyapa, Yoni Kanda, Mudhagarbha, Sutikaroga, Stanya Dushti, Balaroga, and Bisaroga. Total number of chapters are 69. The first chapter is the Nidana Panchaka Lakshana. So as a BMS scholar, he or she should know the all the chapter names thoroughly. What happened in the Dravyaguna Vigyan, when the shlokas are mentioned in the prayoga, where the drug will be therapeutic and administrative. So he or she should know the this is the chapters already in the Madhav Nidana. If on the divisions, see this is the last chapter, the Bisaroga. Before that, this one is the Balaroga, with the pediatric. And before Balaroga, there are the six chapters, Asrugdara, Yoni Vyapak, Yoni Kanda, Mudagarbha, Sutika, Sanya, Drushti, this is all of the gynae-related diseases are there. Before that, point is the Siraroga, Netraroga, Nasa, Karna, Mukharoga, all are the ENT. So this is the main point. You should know that because in the third probe and final year, there is the branches of the clinical subjects. So what happened? The people are thinking that this is the non-clinical subject or paraclinical subject, why will give the importance? No, every subject starting from the Sari Rachana, Sari Kriya, Charas Sahita, Ashtang Hudaya, Dravya Gun, Ras Shastra, Madham, Rog Nidan, Vikruti Vigyan, all subjects have their own importance. So it should have the thorough study with the classical books. Next. See, just I'm highlighting because my topic is on the research. So why there is the six research are there? Everybody should know these six research in the detail because the main point is the Pancha Mahabhuta. In the first that is diagram, that is Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Jala and Prithivi. Combination of the Akasha Vayu, it is the Tikta Rasa, Dosa is the Vata Dosha. In the combination of the Vayu Agni, it is the Katu Rasa, Dosa is the Pitta Dosha. Then combination of the Agni and Jala, it is the Labana Rasa, Dosa is the Kapha Dosha. So we know that there is the Tikta Katu Labana. So again, we have the three point, that is the another rasa kasa amla madhura. So where it happened, in the combination of the aap and prithivi, we are getting the madhura rasa, that is the kapha dosha. Why it is the madhura, where the lavana is there, because in the lavana it is not stable gases. Though it is the production, that is the point of the kapha dosha, but for stability air, the prithi mahatva is required. Sthiratva, sthayitva, it is the symbol of the prithi mahabhuta. So it is the to control all the things, tikta, kattu, lavana, and doshas, that is required the sthayitva of this one. This is the combination of the apan prithi mahabhuta. In the second picture, again it is the first picture, it is the right side, it is the left side. In the combination of the prithivi app, it is the madhurasa, that is the kapha dosha. Then it is the combination of the prithivi and app. Madhura, prithivi and agni, it is the amla rasa, that is the pitta dosha. And prithivi and vayu, that is the kasaya rasa and vata dosha. You cannot combine the prithivi and akasa. So what are common point? In the one side, we are getting three rasa, that is the tikta, katu, lavana. In the other side, we are getting the three rasa, madhura rasa, amla rasa, and kasaya rasa. Simultaneously, we have the three dosa, vata, pitta, and kapha. This is the known as the cycles of the rasas. Next. See, the pictures are there. In the madhura fruits, any fruits which are the madhura, in the starting it is the kasaya. When it is slightly mature, it is the amla. When it is the fully mature, it is the madhura. So it is for the people, that is the, it is the good fruit, it for the, you can take for the good ahara and go for the oshada. But what happens if you are not using that fruit in the properly, it go for the decay. In the decay, it is the full mature, it's the madhura. After some days, it turns the amla, and then it is the kasaya, which is completely spoiled. What happened? This is the evolutionary process, and this one is the reversal process. I just give you one example of that, how the fruits are in the proper up to mature state, and second, how the one fully mature into the spoiled state. Next. This is the most important point. Why we are taking the fruits, combination of the one more rasas. What happened? Dosa is there. Where it is increased, kattu titta kasaya, decreased by the madhura amla lavana, and pitta amla lavana kattu, madhura titta kasaya, kapha, it is the madhura amla lavana, and kattu titta kasaya. And it is the three point that increased by and decreased by. So one should be remember these three lines. It is the very, very important points. What happened? We are taking food. In the food, what happened? Madhura rasa and lavana rasa, these are the preservative bond. When the madhura rasa is there, one should be required to add some lavana rasa. If we will not add lavana rasa, then it is spoiled, then it will go for the madhura rasa turned to the amla rasa. Because just remove the app, app mahabhuta, you will get the prithivi amla, the prithivi and agni, then it will the amla rasa. Next, in amla rasa, that is the one should be add kattu rasa, because amla and kattu rasa are the preservative bond. If you will now not go in the preservative mode, then it is the break into the amla into the kasaya rasa. Just remove the agni, you get the prithivi and vayu. Next, in the kasaya rasa, there is required the tikta rasa, that is the preservative bond. Because prithivi vayu and akasa vayu, just remove the vayu, you will get the prithivi and akasa, which is the kasaya rasa will eliminate the fade away. So this is the concept one should be know, that how our mothers are cooking the foods, and that look, that is giving the sweet taste. What happens if the combination of the rasa is not in the proper way? It gives the bad effect in our body. Next. See, I'm collecting data. I'm not saying that this is my own data. I'm collecting the data, that is the madhura rasa. In madhura rasa, it is the, that is the right side, it is the krimi nidana, that is the arsha medhuroga. In Madhur Rasa, it causes for the Krimi, Arsha, and Medhurvaga. It is all the reference from the Madhav Nidana. So if it is the Arsha, which type of Arsha? That is the Shleshma Arsha or Kapha Arsha. Because the main point is the, because every slokas in Madhav Nidana, it starts from the, what are the causes for these diseases? From this Nidana point of view, it is called that this is the Ahara you are taking. So that's why you are facing this problem. So in the Krimi Nidana, if you analyze the point, it is the Madhura Amla Anitto, the mention is there. In the Shleshma Arsha, it is the Madhura Snigdha Sitani is there. It is the Medhuroga, it is the Madhura Annarish is mentioned there. Next here in Amla, all are different from the Madham Nidana. If you are taking excess amount of the Amla Rasa, you are in the previous history that somebody said that I am liking the Amla Drabya. So what are the problem you can face in the future? That is the Kushtha, Krimi, Amla Pitta, Trishna, Grahani, Vatarakta, Unmada, Pandu, Gulma, Arsha, Krimi, Masurika, Vishpot, Arsha, Visharpa, Rakta Pitta, Vatarakta. Again, the 2 points is the Amla Bhojana and Arna. So what happened? If somebody have the history that we are taking the Amla Rasa regularly, so on the suffering cases, you can justify that. What it will be? It helps the DD, differential diagnosis point of view. This is the point you should know, the that Amla Rasa causes the Disma diseases. That is the Kushta, Krimi, Amla Pitta, Trishna. What the type of Trishna? Bhukta Udbhava Trishna. Grahani, what type of Grahani? It is the Paiti Grahani. Vatarakta, Unma, it is the Pitta Unma. Pandu, Gulma, it is the Hui type of Gulma, it is the Paiti Gulma. Arsha, Pittarsha, Krimi, what is the Purishaja Krimi? Masurika, Vishpot, Shleshmarsha, Kapajarsha, Visharpa, Rakta Pitta, and Vatarakta. Next. In the Lavan cases, same thing. One should be known the Dishmas of Rognidan in the Lavan cases. It is the Kushta, Bhukta Bhavatushna, Vatarakta, Purishaja Krimi, Pitarsha, Masurika, Shleshmarsha, Visharpa, Rakta Pitta, Pandu, and Chaddi. So if you will want take excess amount of Lavana, yeah, in the continuous process, they are taking the Lavana. So we can face this much Roga in our Sarira. In the history, you can get the point that these people are taking the Lavana regularly. Next. See, in the Katu, same thing. Pattika Gulma, Pattika Shula, Pittarsha, Masurika, Visport, Paitika Grahani, Vatika Grahani, Vatarakta, Paitikunma, Visharpa, Rakta Pitta, and Vatarsha. So, if you taking the continuous Katurasya Drabya in our Ahara, so this much problem you can face in the future, or in the Didi, you can see that whether it is the Paitik Gulma or any point of view, the Paitika Shula is there. So, one should know the Madhav Nidhan properly, because it is the main point. What is the treatment line, what happened? Nidana Parivarjanam. Nidana Parivarjan, what will go for that? That is the Ahara Nidana Parivarjan and Bihar Nidana Parivarjanam. If Ahara, then what type of Ahara? So in the history, you can say that due to the Katurasa, so you are facing the Gulma. So you should be aware of the Katurasa. Next. In Pitta, it is the 4 points, that is the Hrudroga, Vatiya Grahani, Vatika Shula, and Vatarsha. It is not all are in the mentioned in the Madhav Nidana. Next. In Kashaya, that is the Vatika Bhagandara, second Hrudroga, Grahani, Vatika Shula, and Vatarsha. Here see that in Kashaya, in the all the rogas, there is the point in the Vatas, at the Vatajarsha, Vatika Shula, Vatika Grahani, Hrudroga, and Vatika Bhagandara. Next. See, I'm just concentrating with the Madhur Rasa. That is, all the six rasas are their gunas, and there is also Atimatra Prayukta Madhur Rasa dosas is there. Same thing, Lavana have the dosas, Amla have dosas, Katu also dosas, Pitta also doshas and Kasha also doshas. So everybody should have known the rasa. What is the madhu rasa? If you go in the guna, it is the sita, dhatu, stanya, balaprada, chakshusha, vata pitagna, stolya, mala, krimikara, vishagna, pichila, snigdha, pritya, ayushahita, vranam, kantya, guru, sandhana. From whom you can give that? Bala, vriddha, kshata, kshina, varna, kesha, indriya, and vajra. But main point you should know in the clinical practice, if you will go for the excess amount of the madhurasa, what will happen? That is the jura, swasa, galaganda, arbud, krimi, and stolya. Agnimandya, meha, puryan, meha, medha, and kapha, vyadhi. So I am highlighting the 2 points, arbud and stolya, which I will be discussed in the next slide. Next. See, in the medha roga, the slokas from the Madhana Vidyana medha roga chapters. So one should be just break the slokas only. You get the point. In the first two lines, that is the avyayama, no physical exercise, diva shopna, day sleep, slesma ahara sevitam, that is the kapha provoking diet, madhura anna rasa, madhura substance, sneha, that is sneha. So what happened? It go for the increase of medha, that is the medha pravadayat. Next point. Other dhatus do not get properly nourished as srotas are blocked by the medha. So that is the accumulation of the medha and the point is the medha roga. So the sloka is from the Madhava Nidana. Just in the samprati vigatana samprati, just break the words only. So it is for easy for understanding. Next. See, I am highlighting the point. The clinical sign and symptoms of this stolya. If stolya is there, you should know the 3 points. What are the 3 points? Whether this stolya is due to the ahara, whether it is due to the chikitsa, whether it is the any sutra related chapter. If it is ahara, then what is the? It is due to the madhurasa satmya, whether chikitsa, whether it is the Brihanam, Ati Yoga, or if it is the Medhava Shrotas Vikara, whether it is the Prameha Purvarupa. All are with the reference. In Madhura Rasa, that is Tarasanga Sutrasthana, Ashtasanga Sutrasthana, and Ashtarhuda Sutrasthana. If it is the Chikitsa Vaishyama, that is Brihana Ati Yoga, it is the Ashtarhuda Sutrasthana, and Prameha Purvarupa, it is the Tarasanga and Ashtarhuda. So see the main point. These are the main original classical textbooks. In the Dravyagun, the original classical books is the necessary because there is the main point. Here, see, Dravyagun, we are studying the Madhurasa, but in the Chikitsya, in the Nidana, it is totally reflect that Madhurasa, Satmya, Upayoga. So the main point is it should be known. Next. Here, in the Samprati, that is the dosha, dushya, shrota, dushti. In stolya, dosha is the avalambaka kapha. In avalambaka kapha, it is the pramanata buddhi. In dushya, it is the medha, that is the ati pramana buddhi. Shrotas, medhava shrotas. And dushti, it is the ati prabhuti. So, one should be known what is the samprati of individual diseases. What is the dosha, what is the dushya, what is the shrotas, what is the shrota dushti. Because these are the main points in the Madhava Nidana. Because if you go in the treatment line, I am not switching to the kaya chikitsa. I am just concentration with the Bhavaprakasa Nigantu. In the Bhavaprakasa Nigantu, there is mentioned katu rasa. That is the stolya apakarshana. Matlab, that means in the stolya cases, the best choice of rasa is the katu rasa. If you go analysis the further, that is the trikotuchuna they are using for the stolya. Reference from the Bhavaprakasa Nigantu Haritakyadi Varga. Here it is mentioned that stolya and medha. Some people are using that we have for the stolya treatment, go for the old honey. So Purana Madhu, already mentioned in the Kaidav Nigantu Oshadi Varga, that is the stolya medognam. For the ahara, that is yava, it is also mentioned in the Kaidav Nigantu Dhanya Varga, it is the stolya bilekhana. The point is that all the drugs have their own peculiar characteristics. they have the properties where it will be applicable. So already it is mentioned with Dravya Guna. So if you concern, don't think that this is not a non-clinical subject. It is a clinical subject. One should be go thoroughly, and it should be with the Madhav Nidana. It should be with the Vaishalkalpana Rasastra. It should be with the Charasanhita or other Sushruta Sanhita or Ashtang Hrudaya. So it is required the combination of the all the four chapters are there. Next. Here I am highlighting with the Arbuda. I am not comparing this Arbuda with the modern term. Simply, what are the mention in the Arbuda? I'm just highlighting the point. That is the aggravated doshas in any part of the body. Listen, the point is that it is the Gatra Pradesha. So that's what it mentioned, that aggravated dosha in any part of the body. It is the afflicting the Mamsa and Rakta. Dosha is the Mamsa and Rakta. What happened? It will be, it produces circular, fixed, mild, painful, large, deep-rooted, dense elevation of the Mamsa, which is known as the Arbuda. The reference, the sloka is from the Madhav Nidana. So just cut the point. You get the samprapti of the Arbuda. Next. See, in the clinical sign symptoms, if one body is suffering from the Arbuda, so you should know the 3 points. What are the 3 points? One is whether the Arbuda is due to the Dhatu Vaishyam. If Dhatu Vaishyam, that is the Mamsa, reference from the Ashtasanga Sutrasthana and Ashtanga Hrudaya Sutrasthana. If Arbuda, is it either for the Ahara Vaishyam, it is called the Madhurasa. In previous side, we said that if Madhurasa is excessive intake, then what will happen? It causes the stolia, it causes for the Arbuda. So in Arbuda, the Ahara Vaishyam is the one of the causes. Next, in Rasavashvatas Vikar, it is the Asadhya Vata Rakta. So in Arbuda cases, you should know what are the 3 clinical signs and symptoms, whether it is Dhatu Vaishyam, or it is Ahara Vaishyam, or it is the Rakta Vashvatas Vikara. You should know these 3 points. So reference are there. Dhatu Vaishyama, Ashtana Sangra Sutrasthana, and Ashtana Hrudaya Sutrasthana, Ahara Vaishyama, Sushruta Sutrasthana, and Ashtana Hrudaya Sutrasthana, and Asadhya Vata Rakta case, with the Charasanhita Chikitsasthana 29, Ashtana Sangra Nidhasthana 16, and Ashtana Hrudaya Nidhasthana 16, and Madhurya 23 chapters. Next. See, here is the Samprapti Vikatan, that is the Doshas, it is the Avalambaka Kapha. Here it is the Pramanata Vriddhi. What is the vayu? It is the prana vayu and vyana vayu. It is the karmata vriddhi. And it is the pachak pitta, it is the karma vriddhi. So all the 3 doshas are involved in the arbuda. And dushya, it is the mamsa vriddhi, it is the ankura phal, granthi, rakta vriddhi, rakta srava. Shrotas is the mamsa vashrotas, and dushti is the sangha. That's why in the treatment, it is advised for the sasta karma upachara. I am highlighting 2 points. One is Tavliya, another is the Arbuda. In the one cases, we can go for the Samana Oshadhi Dravya, or Oshadhi, that is the Trikotu Chunna, Purana Madhu, and Yava. But in this case, that is the Arbuda, it is the Sastra Karma Upachara. But if you go in the history, the main point is the Ahara, that is the Madhur Rasa Ati Yoga. Next. See, after complete the point of the roga, we should know the drug in the minimum point of view, not simply rasya guna vire vipaka guna karma prayoga pramukha yoga and useful part. It not solve our aim. If you, I'm giving one example, that is the guruchi. If guruchi, one should know what is the official part. In official part sense, what is the declared by the any official document? We have the official document, that is the API, Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia of India. So in the API, it mentioned that dried mature pieces of stem. So that is the pain point. If the other parts are there, the leaves are used in the guruchi. Next, one should know the botanical names. That is the, it should be updated. Now it is the Tenosphora caudifolia, synonyms, Cocculus, Codiafolius and Menispermum, Codiafolium, family, Meniparmaceae. Next, the main point, where it is available, whether it is the wild sources or cultivated sources, one should be know, if I have the Guduchi, then where I can get the this drug. Next, where it is used. And in the main point, I am highlighting the main point, treat status. That is the whether this drug is listed in the red drug list. Next. See, here I am highlighting the main point, habit and habitat. One should be know that what is the habit and where it is available in our India. I am graphically present. I have mentioned two drugs. One is the Tenospora caudifolia, second one is the Tenospora sinensis. Both plant are looking same. Only difference is that in Tenospora sinensis, in the leaf part, in the shoot part, you will get the hairs. It is hairs is absent in the Tenospora caudifolia. In the sense of this distribution in India, just the coloring point where it is available. So easily, if you go in this way, so you can say that in the this part area, I can get the Guduchi easily. Next. See, the sloka is there. Reference from the Madhav Nigantu, Bhaprakash Nigantu, Guduchi Adibarga, 6/9. What happened? The main point, I previously said that in the Bhaprakash Nigantu slokas, it is in the three sections. One is the synonym, second is the guna, third one is the prayoga. So you just separate the point. You can get the easy point and the slokas. So what happened? In the synonyms, you can get the 21 names of the Guduchi, are the synonyms, the pariyaya. You can get the guna. In guna, you can easily get the, what is the rasa, what is the vipaka, what is the virya, and what is the guna, rasa, guna, virya, vipaka. You can get easily. And in prayoga, it is the, if it is the kamala, kushta, vata, asra, jura, krimi, chardi. Next. See, just I divided the slokas and get the 21 synonyms. Guduchi, Madhupanni, Amruta, Amrutavallari, Chinna, Chinnaruha, Chinno, Bhava, Vaschadani, Jivanti, Tantrika, Soma, Somavalli, Kundali, Chakralakshanika, Dhira, Vishalya, Rasayani, Chandrahasa, Vayastha, Mandali, Devanimrita. So these are the synonyms of the Guduchi mentioned in the Bhaprakash Nigantu. So they have own peculiarities. Just see the point, Chandrahasa. Chandrahasa is the synonym. It is as per the seed of the Guduchi, just like the moon shape. Kundali, it is the habitat of the plant. Just when it grow in the other plant, it just feel like the kundali. Next, Chinna Chinna Ruha, Chinna Udbhava. From the any cut pieces of the Guduchi, it is again arise. So that is the main point. What are the, you should want to know the main synonyms, in which basis it is naming. It should be required for the names. Next. In the sloka again, in the Gunakarma, just divided the point. Katu Tikta Kasaya, it is the stand for the rasa. Shadupaka, that is the vipaka. Ladvi, laghu, that is the guna. Ushna, that is the virya. Then, what are the main 4 points? Rasayani, sangrahini, balya, agnidipani. So again, you just go for the analysis. Why it is rasayani? It may be due to the madhur vipaka. What is the sangrahi? There is the rasa is there. Tikta and katurasa, which attack the dipana and pachana. It is the pakvashat, it is the ushnaviri there. So that's why it is act on the pakvashaya drava. So it just look like it act as a grahi. Next balya, why it is the, due to the madhur vipaka, it act as a balya. So due to madhur vipaka, it help in the growing of the all dhatus, then it help for the balya. Next, agnidipani. In agnidipani, Why it is? Due to the tikta and kathurasa. So one should be analysis, simply remembering the point, it is katu tikta kasaya swadupaka laghu and ushna. That is not the point. There should be applied point. Why it is called rasayani, why it is called grahani, grahi, why it is called balya, why it is agnidipani. One should be analysis the point. If you analyze the point, then it is easy for the another section, that is the prayog. Next. See, in the prayog, it is the tridoshaman, ama, trura, that is the trishna, daha, meha, kasa, pandu, kamala, kushta, vatasra, jora, krimi, vomi, that is the vamana, prameha, swasa, kasa, arsha, krishya, that is the mutra krishya, hudraka vata. So Guruji can give what type of jura one should know, the vata jura and vata kapha jura. It is in the vishama jura, it is the jirna jura. Again, Guruji you can give, but there is the difference of the other drugs are the anupanas. In the vata jura, vata kapha jura, that is the vata of the Guruji and pippali. Vata of the Guruji and pippali mula, it is indicated in the vata jura and vata kapha jura. In the vishama jura cases, there is the Guruji shwaras. In case of jinna jura, it is the Guruji shwara, Guruji kalka sadhita, ghrita. So one should be go in the detail as per the Sahita, as per the other books, that if it is indicated that Guruji is the jura, so which type of jura it is applicable, one should be know. Next, in arsha, that is the it may be Guruji swarasa or maybe Guruji churna with the buttermilk. If it is the prameha, it is the Guruji swarasa with the madhu. If it is amabata, it is the Guruji patha with the nagara, that is the shunti. Next, vatarakta, that is the Guruji sadhita tele. Next, after panchakarma, that is the Guruji kasaya with the silajukti, best for the vatarakta. So if there is the point, so one should the analysis as per the Sahita, as per the classical textbooks, in which jura the Guruji is applicable, in which arsha it is applicable, in which prameha it is applicable. So that is the analysis point. So all the things one should be required the original classical textbooks. It may be Chara Sahita, may be Sushruta Sahita, may be Ashtanghudaya, may be Saranda Sahita, may be Bhavprakash, may be other classical textbooks mentioned in the Ayurveda. Next. See, in Guruji, simply one drug, how many kalpas we can go for this? You can go for the Guruji Churna, you can go for the Guruji Kvatha, you can go for the Guruji Ghrita, go for the Taila and Sattva. The simply drug is one, but the kalpas are the five. So one can easily prepare the Guruji Churna, one can prepare the Kvatha, Ghrita, Taila, Sattva easily. It is no problem. It is known as the single drug therapy. Every drug has the single drug therapy and multi-combination therapy. In the multi-formulation, there is the drugs are available, that is the Amrita Rishta, Guruji Taila, Amrita Adi Churna, Guruji Sattva, Chinna Dhavadi Kvatha, Guruji Adi Kvatha. But here, one should be remember what is the Sandarbhita Grantha and what is the Rogadhikara. If you simply remember the point Amrita Rishta, it is not good for our treatment line. One should be know if it is Amrita Rishta, what is the Sandarbhita Grantha, whether it is the any classical textbook? Yes, it is the Vaishyaratnavali. What is the main Rogadhikara? It is the Joradi Rogadhikara. Already it is mentioned in the Bhapakash Nighantu, the other Grantha, that is the Guruji act on the Jora. In the previously already discussed that is point. It is the Vata Jora, Vata Kapacha Jora, Vishama Jora, Jinna Jora. So what is the main point? It is the Amrita Rishta, reference is the book, reference book is the Vaishyaratnavali, Rogadhikara the Jora. Same thing in the Guruji Taila, reference is the Bhavprakash. Here it is mentioned the Vata Rakta Adhikara. It is for the Vata Rakta. Next, in Guruji Sattva, what is the reference? It is the Yogaratnakara, that is the Rajakshma Chikisya. It is the Guruchi Gurichadi Kanda Pathachurna. It is the Brontha Nikhandu Ratnakara. That is the Vata Jara Prakarana. So on the analysis, the individual formulation, its original textbooks, and its the Rogadikara, it is easy for us where it will be applicable. If it is, you don't have the formulation, then you can go for single drug therapy, you can go for the Gurichurna, you can go for the Kwatha, Taila, Gruta, and Sapta. Next. See, this is the Charasanhita, Srushtasanhita, Ashtanghrudaya. In the sloka numbers, you can get the Guruchi. Guruchi available in the Charasanhita, Sutrasthana, Vimanasthana, Sarirasthana, Chikishasthana, Kalpasthana, Siddhisthana. So, what is the importance of the classical Ayurvedic books? This data will not available any short notes, any reference book or any PDF mobile file. So we should have the original textbooks. In the Guruchi, it is available in Sutra Santa, that is the Sutrasthana, Chikishasthana, Uttasthana. In Ashtanghruda, it is the Sutrasthana, Sarirasthana, Chikishasthana, Kalpasthana, Uttarasthana. So these are our the main books of the Ayurveda. We cannot forget or any avoid these original books. So one should have the three books, that is the Charasanhita, Sutrasthana, and Ashtanghrudaya. It is very, very important for our clinical practice. Next. See, this is the library, which is totally empty. But the library are the community treasure chest loaded with the wealth of information available to everyone equally. We can purchase one book, it is okay. We cannot purchase two, three, or four books, but all the books are available in the library. So my request, sincerely request to all, please utilize your library properly and enjoy it, not in the stress and strain mode. It should be in the enjoy mode. Next. See. One should be enjoy the library in the proper way, not in the stress and strain. Just utilize. If there is no chairs, no, don't worry for that. Go in the floor. So what are the books are there? One should be used in the proper way. And all the books will be available in the library. So just collect it, collect the data, simplify it, you get the new words, new things, new points, which will be more helpful for your treatment line. So in my conclusion, the first point is that one should be have the original classical textbook, not in the reference book, not in form of the short notes, not in the form of the mobile PDF file. This is my sincere request. Always refer the original textbooks. And the best knowledge room is the library. Just utilize it. Next. Thank you. You have any questions? Because all I think I have put in mind that all are from reference. I'm not saying that this is from my own experience. It is all are from the mentioned in the textbooks. Let's read in the classical Ayurvedic books. Next. Thank you.
It was most informative session, sir. And you rightly highlighted the importance of classical textbooks in learning Ayurveda. And we are grateful for the time and efforts you took to share your knowledge and experience with us, sir. Thank you. And okay, there are a few questions, sir.
Okay.
First question is, sir. Sir, you explained about Raktasthambhagna, like Nagakeshara for Raktarsha, Bola for Rakta Pradhara, and Lodra, yeah, for Raktatisara. So how can we justify this? Means Lodra Savak is also indicated for Rakta Pradhara.
Like, so. Yeah.
Just please elaborate the same.
No, okay. My point is that before going to the any roga, one should be know that what is the samprapti vighatana. What is the dosha, dushya, and shrotas. in my reference in the that is the 3 point Nakasara, Lodhra and Mocharasa. Here dosha and dusha are the same, but shrutas are different. On the basis of the shruta, if you go my slide that if you just go for the one slide, that is where the rasa panchakara more potent in the which one, in the samprati vighatan. Can you go on that slide? In one tabular form, I mentioned that in Kosta, general circulation. I think it is the 7th or 8th number slide, I think. The relation between the rasa panchaka and next. No, again. I think 2-3 more slides are there. See, this is the main point. Just before this one. No, just previous one. Previous one. See, we know this slide. What happened? In the three cases, it is the dosha and dushya. But samprapti is different and their difference is due to the different srutamsi. Main point is the involvement of the srutas are there. In Nakyasara, what is Nakyasara? It is the kasaya tikta madhura rasa. And its main karma, it is the rakta prasadana and rakta stamban. Okay, what is the Nakyasara? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
It is the Nakyasara. Nakyasara is the kasaya tikta madhura. It's virya is the ushna. If you go in the karma, it is the rakta prasadana and rakta stamban. Where I indicated? It is the indicated in the raktarsha. In arsha, what is the basic nidan is there? You one should be know, because the main point is the chaya, prakapa, prasara, sthana sanshaya and vyakta. If it is chaya avastha, go for the rasa. If it is prakapa avastha, it is by the vipaka. In the prasara, it is the guna. In the sthana sanshaya, it is the virya and vyakta is the prabhava. It is not formulated by me. It is the book, it is mentioned in the book, that is the by the Acharya Sivcharan Dhyani, that is the Rasa Panchaka. It is a small book, but it is very much informative. Their analysis, that relation between the Rasa Panchaka and Samprapti Vighatan, or Samprapti, Chaya, Prakav, Prasara, Stansasa, Vyakta. So, in the classical books, there is mentioned that the Nakyasara is best for the Raktarsha, Mocharasa is the Rakta Pradara, and Lodhra is the Raktatishara. So, you can give the medicine in the raktarsha, no problem. But the main thing, it is the involvement of the srutas. In the analysis point of view, just I'm giving one few example that is the in the one drug is the yashti madhu. Already most people are using by the kasa and swasa. It is clear? So
yes, sir.
Whether the yashti madhu act in the kasa and swasa? No. It is not directly involved in the kasahara and swasahara. Because if you go in the property of the yashti madhu, it is act on the at the kantya. It act as the kapha nisarana. Because if you analysis in the kasa, there is the 5 type of kasa is there. That is the vataj, pittaj, kaphaj, khyataj and khyaj. In swasa, it is one point of the tamak swasa. So like that. one should be going, it is a drug of choice. One should be know what is the rasapancha and one should be know what is the samprapti of the particular diseases. So just analysis the arsha, raktapadara and atisara. After that you go for the any choice of drug. Just I am giving the example that is the mentioned in the book, Acharya Sivacharan Dhyani book, that is Rasapanchaka, that is Nakyasara and Vacharasa Lodhra, why it is important, and because the here it is dosha and dosha are same, but the shrotas, involvement shrotas are different.
Okay, sir. So next question, sir.
Yep.
Sir, are there any drug of choices for particular dhatu vaishamya?
Dhatu vaishamya.
Varasa dhatu, rakta dhatu, like vaishamya.
No. In my point of view, what will happen? I giving the one reference that is, if it is rakta dhatu, okay.
Yes.
Just analysis the point of view. That again, I repeat the point, same point. In kasa, what is kasa? It is the vataja, pittaja, kaphaja, and kshetaja and kshayaja. Okay.
Yes.
If you analysis the point in kshetaja, kshayaja, there is the involvement of the rakta dhatu. If you go samprapti, there is the involvement of the rakta dhatu in the kshayaja and kshetaja. If analysis the point of the all five type of kasas, there is the involvement of the pranavayu and udanavayu. In the pranavayu udanavayu, it is the rukshata guna buddhi. That is the main point. But the it is buddhi, it is the gunata buddhi. So this type should be analysis. So the drug of choice, if it is the raktadhatu involvement in the kasa cases, in the kshataja kshayaja, the drug of choice is the yashtimadhu. The main point. So what happened? Because in yashtimadhu, in the all the classes, the dushya you can get in the main point, that is the kantha pradesha. So yashtimadhu act as a kantha and kapha nisharaka. That is the main point. So we cannot say this drug is only particular for this one. You cannot say this like this. So you should be go for the samprapti vighatana. The samprapti vighatana is the main point. In the same thing, I am analyzing in the stolya and arbuda. So always see the what is the dosha, dushya, shrotas and shuddhushti. That is the main basic point. After that, you go for the drug of choice. So just directly see that this the drug is best for this one. It is okay. But after that, you go for the again clarification and further study the whether it is the good for this one, because if it is yashtimadhu there, it is known as the which one antihistamine or which one it is expected. Good for the expectorant, it is good for the bronchial asthma. But in the classical text, in there is no reference regarding the kasa and swasahara. It is the clearly mentioned, it is the kantha and kapha nisharaka.
Okay, sir. So next question, sir. So yeah. Mode of action of guruji in COVID-19.
Guruji in the COVID-19, I'm sorry, because the main point already I discussed in the point, Guruji is good for the Vata Jwara, Vata Kaphaja Jwara, Jinna Jwara and Vishama Jwara. This is the classical reference. So we cannot say that it can be active in the COVID-19, but I cannot claim that it will be very effective in the COVID-19. Sorry, ma'am. Because always okay. My point is that you should go in the only original classical text reference, because there are so many drugs are there which are now in the research mode, whether it is there active in the Guruji or COVID-19 or not. Because most people are just simply, I'm not blaming anybody. What happened? We are using Tulsi in the Kadha.
Yes.
Okay. So if you analyze the point Tulsi, it is the Pitta Vardhak. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
That is mentioned the Pitta Vardhak. So,
yes.
What you will do if you are using the drug Tulsi in the Kadha? So, it used to give the advisory. That is mentioned when you use the Kadha, it should be with the Munka, Draksha, or Madhu. which is the madhurasa. So what happened? It will minimize the toxic effect or minimize the side effect of the pitta jaroga. So there is the combination of drugs are there. If you go analysis the another view of the point, the antidote, you can say the antidote of the drug. So where pipali and marich are there, you see the anupan is the madhu or guda or any other madhura dravya are there. So what will be, it is just antidote or anti, just minimize the toxic effect of a particular drug.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome.
So just before concluding the session, I would like to request Dr. Prakash Tarewad, Professor, HOD, Department of Dravyaguna, SVM AMC, Ilkal, for vote of thanks.
Good afternoon to all the viewers. So today we have completed this national webinar, Dravya Sampada 2020. Today we had a session on the basic concepts of Dravyaguna by Dr. Om Prakash Rao. So it is the end of today's session. With vote of thanks, myself, Dr. Prakash Tarewad, Professor in HOD Department of Dravyaguna. First and foremost, it is my privilege to thanks with the blessings of His Holiness Sri Manipura Guru Mahanta Swamiji as the event started by the blessings of Swamiji. Thank you, Swamiji. So I thank to our SVM Sangha, the Chairman, Secretary, and the Board of Directors, and all the members supported to organize this national webinar, Dravya Sampada 2020. Thank you, sir. So I thank our today's speaker, Dr. Om Prakash Rao, sir, reader, Department of Dravyaguna, Government Ayurvedic Medical College, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Sir, I took a talk on the basic concepts of Dravyaguna. Today, this is very essential for all the doctors and wedding doctors because it is the foundation for all the medicines. So thank you, sir. So I thank to our event president, Dr. K.C. Das, sir, principal and professor, SVM Ayurvedic Medical College, for his support and advice in organizing this national webinar. Thank you, sir. I thank to the event secretary, Dr. Mukhtar Ali, associate professor, Department of Dravyaguna, being the secretary and organizing this national webinar, Dravya Sampada 2020. Thank you, madam. I extend the thanks to all my teaching staff and non-teaching staff, PG and UG scholars, and the students of our institution and the students of other institutions and all the doctors. Thank you, sir. I thank to the all the teachers, PG scholars and UG scholars for participating in this national webinar, Dravya Sampada 2020. Thank you all the participants. Lastly, I thank to people who had helped directly and indirectly in organizing and conducting this national webinar, Dravya Sampada 2020. Thank you, sir. Thank you one and all.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. We'll close the session.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.